Now, electric field intensity due to uniformly charged sphere. So there is a sphere. Now, this is all uniformly charged inside also, not on the surface, but everywhere. Now, let us, because this is a spherical type structure, so we have to take rho. Rho is the volume charge density. And this rho is given by Q by volume. Volume is, for a sphere, it will be 4 by 3 pi r cube. So, rho becomes rho into this volume, that is rho into 4 by 3 pi r cube will be our charge. So, this is the charge. So, electric field due to such a sphere will be always radial. It will be radial like this. It goes outside radially. So, we need to determine the electric field at points inside and outside the charge sphere. So, what we will do, if this is a sphere, inside means we will take a Gaussian surface here, say some r dash, and this is capital R, from here to here capital R, and we will take for outside a Gaussian surface. Now, this will be say some distance r. Inside will be r dash, outside will be r, and actual radius of this uniformly charged sphere is capital R. So, a point which is lying inside the sphere, say here inside the sphere, this r dash is less than capital R, means actual radius is r, and this we are taking a Gaussian surface which is inside this uniformly charged sphere. So, Q dash will be what? 4 by 3 pi r dash whole cube, rho. This we know how to find out the charge. So, 4 by 3 pi r cube, rho we know. What is rho? By this. We can replace Q by 4 by 3 pi r cube. See, this r is the radius of this sphere. This r dash is the radius of the Gaussian surface which is inside this radius. So, Q dash has a relationship with Q. R dash cube by r cube. So, by Gaussian surface, we know when we take a Gaussian surface, the electric flux is integration of E dot dA equal to Q dash. This is the charge in Gaussian surface by epsilon naught. So, E will come out at all the points because they are symmetric. The electric field will remain same. E is outside. This is 4 pi R dash square. And this, because Q dash, we need to replace by this. We have replaced Q dash by this. So, this becomes like this. So, E, just take E and L else on the right hand side. So, E becomes like this. If you put Q from this equation, then this same equation will become like this. So, this is the electric field inside a sphere, uniformly charged sphere. Now, if you want to find out at this point, some point which is outside this uniformly charged sphere, so, we will take a Gaussian surface which is outside here. Let us take the radius as r, which is greater than actual radius of the sphere. So, according to Gaussian law, E dot dA is equal to Q by epsilon naught. E dA is Q by epsilon naught. And what is the surface area of this Gaussian surface? 4 pi r square. Electricity or electric field will be common because all the points are at same distance. So, this dA becomes 4 pi r square. Integration of this dA becomes 4 pi r square. So, E is like this. 1 by 4 pi epsilon q by r square. So, this is showing that the point which is outside this sphere, the entire charge of a sphere can be considered at the center. And E varies like 1 by r square. So, in this, if you put a q equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube into rho, this equation becomes like this. So, these both are same. Here we have rho which is being introduced. As you see here, that if we have a uniformly charged sphere at from this point to this point, this varies directly proportional to r. At the surface, it is maximum. Then after, if you go outside, at these point, it reduces with respect to r square. That is, it is inversely proportional to r square. See, inversely proportional to r square. So, this is the graphical representation of electric field of a charged sphere.